No, for Sunday match, not back. Both of them not back, but also no other injuries.
I was going to ask you about the Stamford Bridge playing surface you mentioned the other night. What are the reasons that it is in poor shape at the moment, and what are the solutions for you ahead of this game against West Ham?
I don't know. I'm not a specialist on it, and we're looking into highest level in every department, and I know that everybody is trying hard. I know, but I said it because the first goal was like the mistake from Andreas, but the mistake was because of a funny bounce of the ball, and we had more of them in the game. It was like a bit it was a bit awkward to play and to calculate the speed and the bounce of the ball, and this one is clearly has a clear relationship, and well, it's like this, so that was it, but it's I know that everybody's working hard, and I know that everybody's working hard in every department and want to provide the best level, and so we try and keep on going.
Any perceived problems with the pitch? Is it related to the ongoing takeover
At
situation?
home, to
Is
no
there
no no
the
no
problem
no
with the
no no
pitch?
no 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 no. The demands are high. The demands are high from the manager. That's a bit the problem, and we were struggling a little bit with the timing of the renewal this season, and yeah, that then this leads to a bit of the problem. So the pitch was in the beginning of the season not where it should be and where it could be, and we saw it and we felt it when we had away matches, and that's why it was a bit of a, and this one was now, like I said, a funny bounce and given to the given to the quality of the pitch at this moment, and that cost us.
On the takeover situation, what do you make of Lewis Hamilton and Serena Williams joining one of the bids?
I just heard it. I just got a briefing and heard it that they are part of it. Well, I can tell you not more than I'm a big admirer of both of them. They're fantastic sports personalities, fantastic personalities on the court, on the racetrack, and off. Who take responsibility as persons, as human beings, and are outstanding. Sport figures in what they do, which is yeah, which for which they have our biggest and my biggest respect. But I have absolutely no insight into the proceeding and then what role they play. So I would like to not comment.
Does it bother you that Lewis Hamilton is seemingly an Arsenal fan, or is this business?
That might explain something regarding 2 days ago, but hopefully no influence for the West Ham game.
And just a final one on the top four race. How do you call it at the moment? Do you feel secure in that third
We
spot?
never feel secure. I never feel secure in Premier League. That's my personal feeling, and I think it's good. I think nobody should, never, because it's feeling secure does not keep you on the edge, and feeling secure is just very, very close and thin line to being lazy or not being fully alert. Maybe that's better because nobody's lazy, but not fully alert. So no, I never feel safe in no part of the season, and nobody should in Premier League.
John Southall, Five Live.
Hi Thomas, I'm sure you've dissected the video from the Arsenal game. Has your opinion changed at all on what you said the other night, and what have you learned from it?
Well, we have it's you don't need to lose this match, first of all, not with this kind of performance and not how the match is running. We have a bit of a, I don't know, a bad mix of big individual mistakes and a bit of lack of quality in the one-on-one defensive attitude, behavior in the box and around the box. We get punished for it heavily. I'm not so sure if I have an explanation why. The expected goals that we concede since the national break is a bit higher than normal, which is my responsibility to find, and which is, in my opinion, the responsibility of me. It's about tactics, it's about high pressing, deep pressing, how chances are created to keep the expected goals as low as possible. So this is a bit higher, not dramatically, but we conceded since the national break 12 goals, which is the double amount of expected goals. So it, I think, like most of the times in football, it's a mix of bad luck. It's a big mix of circumstances, bad luck, and the opponent making the very most of what we offer them. But it's also like it's a mix of, like I said, big individual mistakes, and we lack the real determination and attitude in the one-on-one in the box at the moment to really keep maybe the actual goals under the expected goals.
How difficult is it for a manager, or frustrating? You can prepare your team during the week, say you don't know which side's going to turn up at the moment, the one that was away to Real Madrid or the one that lost to Brentford.
Yeah, strange. It was like, you know very well, it was like two matches after the national break, which can sometimes happen. For one match after the national break, it happened to us two matches. But then I had the feeling, and I thought, and I still think, that we had the turnaround already. This match here is I don't think, even if the result is pretty similar, it has not the same similarities like the match against Real Madrid and Brentford at home, in terms of like that we were not disciplined enough or with the ball, or we did crazy and were dragged out of shape. The first half was a wild half, was a bit of an open half, where we like gave an unbelievable goal away. Due to a personal mistake. So once again, like, the amount of individual errors is too high. We should not talk around it, and we cannot talk around it in 22. I think we already have like eight big mistakes that lead direct. I don't know. I would stop it if I knew. And I lost it. So we have these kind of mistakes, and where was I? I don't know, what was the topic?
I was saying, was it a mental, is it a mental thing that you're making mistakes, or you've got more?
That was the interruption that actually made me lose my argumentation.
Last one, John.
We could not compare it. Yeah, and it's awkward, because like in the first half it was an open game. In the second half, I think we controlled it. I think we controlled the counter-attacks better. We were a bit more alert to where control it. And I could not feel it in real time, and not feel it like in when we analyze it, that there is a real danger in second half to lose the second half. In the opposite, I thought we are like totally in charge. We control where we want to control. And then we have like two very, very awkward goals that is like... It's almost impossible to concede three goals like this in a match like this given the quality and the determination that we normally have. But obviously it's in the moment a bit fragile, and in home games, and there's another home game coming, and we have the chance to do it better.
Alex,
Kilpin. Hi. How are you? I'm sure you're aware that Chelsea have played more games than any other side in Europe this season. 55 in all comps, and have gone to extra time. Obviously that takes its toll on the players.
Yeah.
What about the manager? It's not physical tiredness with you, but is there an element of mental fatigue?
Yeah, always, but I'm also used to it, always. And I think I also reflect on what signals did we give. We only had 2 days in between, coming from Wembley and from a very emotional game and a very emotional win to the next match. So like only two days in between. And I felt very tired after the Real Madrid, and after the turnaround, Southampton away, Real Madrid away, and another away game in Wembley. It was tiring, and I felt it. I asked myself, what signals did I give? Should I have pushed harder? Because we did what we were convinced about to do, but you feel it. On an evening game, I think there's still enough time to prepare and to get into the right mood. And I have, for myself, because you asked me, also developed a routine that you don't feel the same level of excitement in before every match. It's for me personally impossible. And you should not expect it. And there's nothing wrong if you sometimes feel a bit like lower level of excitement, lower level of tension. This is also normal, but it has nothing to do that you do it less serious or let you prepare with less quality. And I don't want to get confused in these kind of thinking now, because we can trust ourselves and we prepared in the best way possible. And of course, we are asking ourselves, what is it? Because it came again from out of the blue. But it is a bit of a weird result, given how the game went, a bit different, like the Real Madrid game and the performance in it and the Brentford game for me.
Just one on West Ham, obviously.
Yeah.
Unlucky to lose away there earlier in the season.
Yeah.
Through to Europa League.
With a big mistake.
Fighting for top four finish. What have you made of their season on a whole, and also the job that David Moyes has done?
Well, I think he's doing an incredible job, and this is a very... It's a very popular club and a very emotional club, and a team together in the group with a coach which is enjoyable to watch. Like, we follow the EuroLeague games, and I follow a lot of their games because it's nice to watch, because it's a full investment physically. The players are absolutely tired after their matches. It's a very emotional, very physical squad, very hard to break down, very hard to create chances. Very, very dangerous in counterattacks and set pieces. So there's a lot to take care about, and it needs a lot of physicality and a lot of commitment to stand up against them. But full credit to them, and will be a very tough one, of course.
Last question in the TV section, Nick.
Thomas, if the Premier League table was just home matches, you'd be ninth, and away games, you'd be second, just 2 points behind Man City. Do you have to sort of create that sort of fortress feeling of Stamford Bridge again?
Obviously, I mean, these numbers are. I didn't know that, but it's obvious that we are like behind, and it's very unusual. Very unusual also for me in my experience over the last years. Not only here, it's unusual. I don't know what it is, and yeah, we need to. If we had a solution, if we had the one thing, we would just, like, I don't know. Switch the dressing rooms and like take another hotel or something like this. But this would maybe be more superstition than anything else. So I have no solution, but it is obviously not the level that we want to produce in home games.